So today we're talking about the parietal lobe. In a previous video, I started doing a series about the frontal lobe. And so the frontal lobe is here at the very front. And if you take another hand here and palm, that's about where your frontal lobe is. And then we have these things called sulcuses, or deeper grooves that divide the areas. And then we have these things called sulcuses, or deeper grooves that divide the areas. And if you were to take one more hand back, so we've got frontal, third palm is your parietal. It's at the crown of your head. And if you go one more back, you'll be at occipital. We'll do another video in the future about that. But what is the function of the parietal lobe and what happens if there's damage to it? Hey, this is Tammy with NurseMinder, and we're going to give you some helpful hints here to help you remember the roles and the function of the parietal lobe and what happens when it's damaged. So to help you remember the functions of the parietal lobe, there's only two P's I want you to remember: perception and position. Let's start with perception. Because the parietal lobe is a sensory processing machine, we know that when we perceive an event and we make a judgment, you know, it's coming from our sight, what we hear, what we touch, taste, and smell in the environment in order to create a judgment. So perception involves all of our senses. So that's how you're going to remember the parietal lobe, that it's all sensory. It's kind of like your little antenna up here, and it's taking in all the data and it's giving it meaning based on weight, texture, size, shape, sounds, smells, all of that stuff. It's how I know when I'm driving down the country that the smell is from a skunk. And it's also how I know that that's a large truck or a small dog. Those are things that are being processed sensory-wise inside of the parietal lobe. Now the second P is position. And there's a few parts to this. So the first thing is, where are my body parts in relationship to my body? So is my hand up in the air or is it in my pocket? That kind of thing. And then where am I in relationship to the surrounding environment? So I know that when I look out this window, that's my neighbor's house and I'm in my office. So positionally, I know where I am. And I also can then tell myself and visualize where I want to go. So that's part of the position as well, where I am and where I want to go. And you can map it out just like it's a GPS in your brain. That's part of your parietal lobe. So now with your parietal lobe intact, you can show this to somebody and they go, oh, that's a watch. I recognize that. That's a highlighter and that's a glass. And if I were to taste this, my brain would say, oh, that's water and it's not milk. I would recognize that difference. When somebody doesn't have that ability, if you were to give them something in their hands with their eyes closed, for example, they'd be able to describe what they're feeling. Smooth, long, narrow, blunt end, little handle, maybe a tip at this end. They could describe those pieces, but they wouldn't be able to make a meaningful connection to all of those to tell you it's a pen or a highlighter. And that word is called agnosia. Now I'm going to give you a tip here, because agnosia itself is kind of a funny word. And if you look inside that word and you look at agnosia spelled backwards, you'll see that the word song is right in the middle of it. And song requires our senses of hearing, and you recognize it's a song because your brain has already processed that when you put notes together and different ranges, people are singing, there's different varieties, country, rock, all that kind of stuff. So if you can no longer recognize it, is it still a song? That's your tip to remember. Agnosia is the pathological name for when there's damage to the parietal lobe and people can no longer give meaning to the input of sensory data